The Myris lets you manage your passwords with your eyes. A solid first step toward better password protection. In a world where almost every service we use requires one, keeping track of passwords is a pain. And as incidents like Heartbleed and the bash bug have reminded us, neither are they completely secure. Solutions like password managers and fingerprint sensors aim to alleviate the problem, but it's difficult to strike a fair balance between security and broad affordability. That's exactly what EyeLock is hoping to do with Myris, a new computer accessory that uses iris scanning to authenticate your identity. On sale today for $280, EyeLock has yet to announce availability outside the United States. Myris can help control access to pretty much anything on your computer that requires a password, from websites to your machine itself. As your eyes go, it's cheaper and less invasive than a retinal scanner, but it's only as secure as you allow it to be. As long as you have a password in hand, you can skip the Myris completely. That loophole gives me pause about its almost 3 Benjamins price tag, but I give Myris credit for making the technology more readily available. Give it time to mature, and it's a start to a more secure you. Inside your eyes. Though it's easy to confuse the two, I certainly did when I first heard of Myris. Retinal and iris scanning have only your eye in common. With the former, a laser scans the blood vessel pattern of your retina, which is the nerve layer at the back of your eye. Expensive and complicated, it's a technology that we usually see in spy movies. As such, it's pretty uncommon outside a corporate research lab, FBI headquarters or a supervillain's lair. Iris scanning, however, focuses on your iris, which is the area at the front of your eye that gives it its color and controls the amount of light hitting the retina. Every person's iris is unique, even from each other, with 240 individual markers that give it a pattern. The Myris uses an infrared video camera to capture that pattern, save it. It doesn't save a photo of your eye, and associate it with your identity. According to EyeLock, a thief wouldn't be able to fool it with a photograph of your eye, and the chance of getting a false match with iris scanning is just 1 in 1.5 million. In contrast, the company says, other biometric technology like fingerprint, voice, and facial scanners have fewer markers to work with. And while DNA may even be more secure, who wants to prick their finger each time they check their bank account? Design. EyeLock says that it spent a lot of time thinking about the Myris's design and it shows. Indeed, I very much approve. About the size of a hockey puck, it measures 3 inches in diameter, 76.2 millimeter, and is 1.18 inches thick, 30 mm. Its top surface is covered in an attractive, light blue soft touch material with a small EyeLock logo. It fits comfortably in my hand thanks to the rounded top rim, and it weighs just 3.2 ounces, 90.1 grams. I asked an EyeLock rep if the company had considered making the Myris smaller to keep it even more portable, but he replied that research showed that most people preferred a device the size of an average adult's hand. On the bottom, the Myris has a black translucent plate with a circular mirror near the center. Above that is the lens for the scanning camera. The sturdy USB cable is a generous 4.5 feet, 1.4 meters, long and has a handy Velcro tie that will keep it from getting tangled. Getting started. Setting up the Myris is easy. You need only to take it out of the box and plug the USB cable into your desktop or laptop. Currently, Myris is compatible with Windows 7, 8, and 8.1, and Mac OS X 8.5 and 9.1. Linux support is slated for a future release. True compatibility with mobile devices is also to come as Myris has yet to support either iOS or Android. After you plug in the cable, you'll be prompted to install the software, which takes just a few minutes. You'll then have to register your name and email, both within the software and on EyeLock's website. I'm uncertain why I had to register in both places, but it wasn't taxing. You can store up to 5 user identities on one Myris and move it between computers. The software then asks you to create your unique EyeLock ID by capturing your initial iris scan. There's a video to show you the ropes, which is helpful since it took a few minutes to get the hang of the process, more on that in a minute. To start, you should hold the Myris about 8 to 10 inches away from your face while looking directly at the mirror. The color of the lighted ring surrounding the mirror will indicate the Myris's status. White tells you that it's ready to scan, blue shows that the scan is in progress, and green means that the scan is complete. If you see red, you'll need to try again. If you wear glasses, you'll have to remove them for the initial scan only. On the other hand, you can leave contact lenses in, unless they're distinctly colored.